What's this?
Oh, that. Huh. I found it in Tinker's room. It's a going-away present. Have a look inside. $2,000.
Why would she leave this behind?
Huh. She left this note. She wants it to spend it in the way that Maxine would like. It's her cut of the robbery. Wally, what the hell are we going to do with it?
How is she, Doc?
Not too good, I'm afraid, B.
With Lizzie's heart condition, all we can do is wait and hope.
Why don't you show me how to do that, Doc? I can manage Lizzie.
Look, I know how you feel about it, babe, but there's nothing you can do, really.
Well, I'm not budging from her side, so you might just as well.
All right.
How is she?
Oh, I don't know. Don't know anything. Just wish this is a bad dream and I could wake up in a minute.
I don't know what you mean. Scott's wearing himself into a frazzle, too. All we can do is just wait.
She's dead, isn't she?
What do you want, Hunt?
Lizzie. She snuffed it, hasn't she? And I'm going to be next. All because you put me in that lousy bloody cell with her.
That's enough. Nobody's dead. Now, why don't you make yourself useful? We're running out of clean linen, and I'm sure you can find someone in the laundry to help you.
You don't need clean sheets for dead people. And that's what we all are, you know? Dead. Before this is finished, this place is going to be filled with corpses, and I don't want to...
Enough, Phyllis.
I don't want to end up like that.
No, I'm not going. First of all... Shut up. Get out of here.
You all right?
She's not going to die, Doc, because I'm not going to let her.
Scott.
The fever's broken.
It's crazy, isn't it? Maxine died for this money, and there's nothing we can do with it.
Yes, we can. We can give it back.
Well, that'd be like stabbing her in the back. Doesn't seem fair that it would end like this after all she's been through. To top it off, her family couldn't care about her.
Oh, we can't be sure about that, can we?
Oh, come on, Wally. The only reason she ended up in the slammer last time was because of that sanctimonious brother-in-law of hers and that bitch of a sister. It's just not fair, that's all.
All right, I agree with you. But what are we going to do
about... All right, I know. Let's just talk about the era.
Good girl. What are we going to do with the dough?
Well, we can't take it to the police, can we? Tell them we found it in a rubbish bin somewhere.
All right. We give it back to the factory.
That's a really good idea. We give it back to the factory. The factory owner keeps the money. Then he claims it on the insurance. Oh, brother.
You're a real crook, you know that?
Well, I've learnt from the best.
Tell you what we do. We give it to the insurance company. Now, what could be wrong with that?
Nothing, I suppose.
Right. I'll take care of it. I've got to go out anyway. I want to check some leads with the police. And I won't be happy until this money's out of the house.
Thanks, Wally. From me and Maxine.
Scott.
It's all right. You're going to be fine.
I feel so weak.
Hey, don't try to talk. Just rest, okay?
I feel a bit redundant here, Mrs. Powell. Perhaps I'd be more help in the laundry.
All right. If you don't mind.
Well, no, of course not. I didn't always have a silver spoon in my mouth, you know.
How's she now?
Well, she doesn't seem much better. I suppose we're lucky we're not all down with it.
Yeah. Listen, you haven't seen Wendy Sharp this morning, have you? I thought she was going to relieve you in here.
Well, she was, but I haven't seen her since early yesterday.
No, neither have I. Could be in the hospital with Sister
Kelly.
I'll go and check.
Who is she? No change. But she'll pull through. I know Lizzie.
Oh. Oh, God. My head. I feel like I've been on a week-long pub crawl. Welcome back.
How do you feel?
Oh, starving. Oh, I'd love a piece of steak and...
Mr. Wallace, sit down.
How are things going?
I know you've got a vested interest, Mr. Wallace, and I appreciate your concern, but there's not a lot I can tell you.
What about Harry? Have you heard anything?
We thought we had something. One of the civilian victims was a known fence around the docks area.
Stolen goods, huh?
Not just stolen. Smuggled, mostly. Did a roaring trade with the illicit stuff the seamen brought in.
Oh, he should know this Harry character.
And that's what we thought. We questioned him out at the infectious diseases unit. He wasn't able to say very much, but it appears that he was dealing with a sailor from Africa. And that's not much to go on.
Brady, huh? Well, could we go and see him again? Maybe get an address.
He won't be telling us anything else, Mr. Wallace. He died during the night.
Mrs. Powell? I think you better come to the laundry.
I'm sorry, I'm just on the way
back. Mrs. Powell, please.
I've already checked. She's dead, I'm afraid.
Who the hell is Harry?
Buggered if I know. Every lead finishes in a dead end.
Yeah, we're not having much luck, are we?
Oh, well, don't let her get you down.
I can't help it, Wally. I'm worried about B and Lizzie.
There's no picnic for me either, you know.
Anyone want more coffee?
No, thanks, love.
I'll get it.
Something's just got to break soon, really.
I hope so, I tell you.
Well?
Yeah?
It's a captain somebody on the phone. Says you told him to call you.
Beauty. This could be it.
You're real worried about your mates, aren't you, Jude?
Yes, I am. Oh, I'm sorry, Betty. I hope you don't feel I'm neglecting you.
Oh, no, that's okay. Hell, I got a roof over my head and a bed to sleep in. I'm not complaining. When I was inside, the whole bloody world couldn't wait to twist the knife in my back. Clear this away for you.
Thanks,
Sam. Hey, I think we got it. I think we got the lead we need.
You're kidding.
That was Captain Todd. He reckoned one of his sailors jumped ship in West Africa. He didn't tell me about it because the bloke's name wasn't Harry.
But it was Freddy, right?
Freddy DeYoung, right. Now, I've got an address for him. This is the lead the police need.
Well, what are you standing there for? Go and ring him.
Get something to eat, B. I'll look after Lizzie.
It won't hurt me to lose a few pounds, Doc. She's been making it.
Did you find Wendy?
Can I see?
What's the matter?
Bad news.
Well, it is at stake, but at least I feel human again.
Good news, everyone. Miss Ferguson's out of danger. Her fever's broken.
Well, if that's the good news, I can't imagine what the bad news is going to be.
Come on, girls, please, do me a favor. Just clean this place up a little bit. It's like a pigsty. Oh. Hazel! Hello, Dell. How are you?
Good, Jude.
Come on in. Oh, for heaven's sakes. You're the last person I expected to see.
Well, you know me. Keep turning up like a bad penny.
Come on in here. So, how have you been?
Oh, Fine. Only I went away on a sort of trip, see, and now I got nowhere to stay. They buggered up me social security, Jude. It's only temporary, but, I mean, I promised I wouldn't be here long. I just need somewhere to stay for a few days, like, you know.
Yeah, well, that'd be fine. It's just that the no booze rule still goes here.
Oh, I know. Oh, you still think I'm on the booze? Well, I'm not. I swear I'm not. I haven't touched it for months, as a matter of fact, and I'm not planning to, neither.
Okay, well, I'll trust you, and I'd like you to stay, Hazel. It's just you'll have to tell me what you've been up to. I mean, I couldn't have the cops knocking on the door.
Oh, no, no worries there. I'm clean. Wish it was as simple as that.
Hazel, you all right?
Look, Jude, can I stay here or not?
Sure, love, it's great. Third door on the left upstairs, huh?
Thanks, Jude. I won't let you down. Promise.
I don't think there's any need to tell you that you shouldn't be here, Mr. Wallace.
You're not going to quote the book at me, are you, Inspector? I've got as much at stake as anyone.
All right, I suppose we owe you for this lead.
Thanks a lot. You sure this is what you're looking for?
No worries. We called the airlines after you phoned us, and it seems our little mate up there flew into Australia just over a week ago.
From Africa?
That's right.
Look, I'm still a bit confused. The dead girl kept talking about a Harry. Where does he fit in?
You tell me, but right now my money's on Freddie de Jong.
All set, Inspector. There's about 12 blokes living the place, but most are out or away at sea.
Righto, Chris, you tell Reese to cover the front entrance. We're going up here.
Fine.
I'm coming too.
Now, look, Mr. Wallace, if this bloke is the one we're looking for, he's a heroin pusher. Now, he's not going to welcome us with open arms.
Please, Inspector.
Okay. Now, just do me one favour, will you? You stay right down here.
Don't worry, I won't get in the way.
I'll check upstairs, okay?
Blame the department for all of this.
Oh, can't I? They had no right to admit us to this place while there was any risk. It's pure negligence.
But they had no idea.
Exactly. They have no idea. I'm out of pocket God knows how much. They're going to have to pay me compensation or they'll find themselves up in court.
Oh, for God's sake, Don, I've had a gutful. We've got enough to cope with without listening to a whinging, gutless bastard who's only out for himself.
Well, I must say, that's charming language for a lady. And I use the term advisedly.
You can use the term however you like. Now, whatever I've done in my life, and God knows I'm not proud of all of it, I've never sunk as low as you have in the last couple of days. What's come over you?
You might ask yourself the same thing. I always suspected you weren't quite top drawer. Now you've proved it.
Wake up, Don. Every one of those women has more courage in her little finger than you have in your whole damn body.
Aren't you going to eat that?
I'm not hungry.
Oh, come on, it's not that bad. Try it. See, they've eaten all theirs. Good little girls, huh?
I said I'm not hungry. God's sake, you're not my bloody nursemaid.
Well, sometimes I feel like one.
What do you mean by that?
You know what I mean, Hazel.
Huh. You think I'm back on the piss, do you? Well, why don't you say it?
All right. I'm saying it.
Jeez, I'm sick to death of people throwing the past up in my face. And I'm tired of being called a liar. Why don't you trust me? I told you the cops aren't after me.
All right, I've got a few problems, but they're personal.
So what are you going to do, throw me out if I don't tell you?
I've done it again. I've no right to doubt
you. You had every right. Beginning to wonder myself if she was drunk.
What are we going to do, Wally? I can't throw her out in the street. She's got nowhere to go.
He's up. I'll go and have a chat to her.
Any change?
I think so.
Is she...
She's over the worst of it. Fever's abating.
Oh, thank God.
I don't know how she made it at her age, but she's going to be okay.
Okay, Smith, come on. It is time to get some rest now.
All right, Mrs. Powell. I won't give you an argument this time.
Yeah, well, time I made a move too. See you in the morning.
Good night, Tony. Thanks for everything.
Oh, what about you, Scott? Now that Lizzie's on the mend, you need some rest.
Why not? You seem to be over the worst of it.
I think we're going to make it.
Come searching for grog bottles, have you? Well, go ahead. You won't find any.
I just wanted to have a talk to you. Judy's worried sick about you.
Yeah? Well, she's got a bloody funny way of showing it. Tranquilizers. The doc give them to me. My nerves have been shot since I lost the kids. The only trouble is they make me pretty bombed. Can hardly see straight.
Pity you didn't tell Judy. Would have explained a lot of things.
Why should I? I'm fed up to the teeth making excuses to people who don't want to listen.
I want to listen. Tell me about your kids.
I lost them, didn't I? George got custody of them and took them away from me.
Why?
Geez, they were lovely kids. Never talked back to me or nothing. It was awful not being able to give them things. Because I wanted to. They deserved it. We were in the gardens one day. They wanted an ice cream. I couldn't give it to them. We were broke. Do you know what the little buggers did? They went off and picked the loveliest bunch of flowers you've ever seen. See, George is right, really. I don't deserve them. But bloody no hope.
You are if you think you are.
I've got to see him now, though. I've got to. Something I've got to tell him. They've got to know. Yeah. I've got to know.
How long have you been there?
No, I just arrived.
I don't remember sitting down.
Yeah, how you feel? Hey, fancy a cuppa?
Yeah. All the time I kept saying that she wasn't going to die. There's a voice in my head that keeps saying, what if she does?
Hey.
What if Lizzie does die?
Hey, come on, she's going to be fine. Someone's obviously watching over Lizzie. You're the one I'm worried about, you know. You're the one that needs looking after.
Oh, I'm all right.
Now the worst is over, maybe you'll stop worrying about everyone else, eh? You know, I was watching you today. You really do care so much for that old lady. You're a wonderful person, B. You really are. B.
Of course, we can't go, but I'll organise a wreath from the women. And I thought perhaps something from all of us, too.
Good idea. And that will please the women.
This Maxi girl seems very special to you.
Well, to most of us, they're not just prisoners. We do get to know them very well.
Some of those women have just been remarkable, the way they've handled this lesser fever thing.
Yes. That's why it seems even more tragic when someone like Maxi dies so senselessly. She was only 20 years old.
Oh, poor kid.
Morning.
Morning.
Ah, coffee, just what the doctor ordered.
We would have woken you earlier, but when I looked in, you were out like a light.
Yes, I could have slept standing up last night.
Do you still think the worst is over?
Well, everyone seems to be on the mend. Smart and Roberts have got no temperature. Meg's taken them to the showers, and then they'll rest in their cells. But as for Joan Ferguson...
What?
Quite frankly, she's driving me up the wall. She insists she's well enough to go back to work, but she's still running a high temperature.
Well, then she must stay in bed.
That's what I told her, but I just don't seem to be able to get through it.
I'll have a word with her.
Well, what happens now if no one else gets this fever?
Well, we're almost through the incubation period. The next 24 hours could be the crunch. If we get through that, I think the quarantine will be lifted.
Hi.
Morning.
You got dressed early?
Yeah, well, I didn't see much point in changing for the funeral later.
You sure you don't want me to come with you?
No, Wally. I'd rather you stayed here. I'd feel better. Anyway, I know how you hate saying goodbyes.
Oh, just made it. How's Hazel?
Well, you know Hazel. It's hard to tell. She wandered down this morning. She had a cup of coffee, but she wouldn't eat anything. She said she wanted to go to the funeral. Now, I think that's a lousy idea. She's too depressed.
I don't think those tranquilizers are doing her much good.
Huh. Well, they're killing her appetite, that's for sure.
It's not just the pills, either. She's breaking her heart over those kids. Wish there was something we could do about it.
Yeah, but how? You've seen her. There's not a court in the world that would let her look after two little kids.
I don't know. As I told her last night, I don't see any reason why she can't at least see them. A mate of mine's a solicitor. I think I'll give him a ring. Get him to check out the legal angle. Never know. We might get a lead on this George.
That's a good idea, Wally. I mean, there must be something we can do for her. I just can't let her go on disrupting the house. Is she still okay?
Yeah, coming along quite nicely. But I'm surprised Smith hasn't resumed a vigil.
Yeah, well, I've just checked her cell. Fast asleep.
Good, she deserves it.
Hello, where's Joan?
Oh, Meg took her to the showers. She's not the easiest person to cope with when she's sick.
She's not exactly a lamb when she's well, believe me.
Well, she's still running a temperature. I don't think she'll be returning to work for a while. How are the other two ladies?
Well, Smart and Roberts, they're resting. Pretty weak, but they've eaten a good breakfast.
Good. Look, don't underestimate this thing. It's going to take everyone a while to get over it. It's not like a headache that just miraculously disappears.
Dr. Collins, where's your white coat?
Pardon?
Your white coat. All doctors should wear a white coat.
I'm sorry, Pixie. I haven't had time for the niceties yet. But I must say, it's nice to see someone coming in here fighting fit.
Oh, me? I wouldn't fight anyone, but I am fit. I've always been healthy, you know. I never even get a cold. I can wash it for you if you like.
Huh?
Your white coat. I'm here to collect the dirty linen for the laundry.
Then why don't you do just that?
Oh, right. Isn't it lovely that everybody's getting better?
Yes, it's marvellous. If we get through today, I think the quarantine will be lifted.
Oh, you must be so pleased. I can imagine how worried you were, especially seeing poor Petra so ill. I know if it was somebody I loved, Well, doctors do love everybody, don't they? Oh, well, not exactly love, but they help everybody, don't they?
Yes. Why don't you get back to the laundry?
Yes, Mrs. Powell.
She does go on a bit, doesn't she? Pretty hard to follow most of the time.
But not all of the time. There is something between you and Petra, isn't there? I saw how you reacted when she collapsed.
Well, I am her doctor.
No, I'm not talking about a bedside manner, and I'm not trying to pry, but there are rules.
Look, I know there are rules, but sometimes they're not easy to follow.
So there is something.
Look, I didn't say that. Look, I just don't want to say any more about it. If you want answers, perhaps you better talk to Mrs. Reynolds. That's all I'm going to say.
Funerals give me the bloody creeps. We're all a bunch of hypocrites anyhow.
Who are?
People who turn up at funerals. Would pick you out of the gutter when you're alive. Then they turn up at the graveside to moan and cry about how much they're going to miss you.
What's the matter with you, Hazel? Maxine was our friend. I don't have to pretend that I'm going to miss her.
Yeah, I know. It's not Maxie. But us going to her funeral's not going to help her, is it?
Well, maybe not, but it might help us. God, you have to give yourself time to grieve. Anyway, if there's anything in afterlife, don't you think Maxine would like to know that we cared about her enough to say goodbye to her?
Yeah, well, I'll be nobody to say goodbye when I die. They've said it already.
Oh, for heaven's sake, will you stop feeling sorry for yourself for 5 minutes? Have a look around you. Sometimes it's a pretty good thing just to be alive. Are you coming or not? We're going to be late.
I don't know, Jude. I've got a splitting headache.
Hazel.
I can't, Jude. I just can't.
What I am saying is I don't like being kept in the dark. I am the deputy governor.
Colleen, I never meant to shut you up, believe me.
Then why on earth didn't you tell me? That's what I don't understand.
I planned to, but suddenly we were plunged into this quarantine situation. I could hardly dismiss the only medical person on the staff, could I?
Well, it can't go on.
It isn't, believe me. I've got Scott's word that nothing has or will happen between them. He just wanted to be close to her, that's all.
Yeah. Oh, God only knows what we would have done without him for the past few days.
Exactly. And if he goes, how long do you think it'll be before we get another one?
If we get another one. We can't afford to lose him.
I couldn't agree more.
Oh. I've been overreacting, haven't I?
Perhaps a little, but you had damn good reason.
Yeah. And a bruised ego.
Rubbish. You felt slighted, and it's my fault. I thought you realized how much I depend on you.
Well, considering the strain we've all been under, I think you've done wonders.
I think maybe we ought to adjourn this Mutual Admiration Society before it gets out of hand.
And we ask you to remember, Lord, that this was a child who often strayed from your path, and yet had a kind heart and a love for life that endeared her to those who knew her well.
Oh, Maxine.
So we commend her soul now to your infinite mercy and love. Amen.
I'm gonna miss you, you crazy kid.
Have a word with Mrs. Daniels.
Well, it's not really the right time or place.
Well, I was a really good friend of Maxine's. We were through a lot together.
I see. You're...
Judy Bryant.
Are you from that Driscoll house, right?
Well, you don't sound very impressed.
Well, can you blame me? Maxie should have stayed at home with her family. Instead, she goes off to you people.
I'm sorry, but I don't think that's very fair, Mr.
Carter?
Roger Carter, huh? Her brother-in-law.
Yes, that's right.
Well, I know this isn't the time to air dirty linen, Mr. Carter, but if you and the family had been more understanding of Maxine, she wouldn't have had to run away.
You don't know what you're talking about. We all loved Maxine.
Yeah, well, you had a funny way of showing it. Her own sister didn't even come to the funeral.
She's pregnant, Brian. Her doctor wouldn't let her come. Hell, I don't know why I'm bothering to make excuses for you. Maxine was a disgrace to the whole family.
A disgrace? Are you forgetting something? If it wasn't for Maxine coming for you and that money, you'd be inside right now.
Shut up! Sorry. You're right. Maxine's Pixie's dead now. We have to think of the living, don't we?
Well, I'm glad in one way she is. She didn't have to discover what her family was really like.
And there I stood with my foot in my mouth, and Mrs. Powell was looking daggers at Dr. Collins, and he looked like he'd just swallowed his stethoscope.
Sounds pretty uncomfortable.
Well, Pixie's pretty good at putting her foot in it, aren't you, love? Well, I better get back to Lizzie. How is she?
Oh, there's no hurry. She's sleeping like a baby. I bet she'll be relieved when she finds out. And your wife and children, Mr. Maguire, I bet they'll be relieved too.
Look, I'm a bachelor from way back, Pixie. No wife or kids that I know of.
Oh, what a pity. You'll have no one to celebrate with.
Back up, Pixie. What's all this about celebrating?
What didn't I tell you? Oh, well, Dr. Collins says the quarantine will be over tomorrow so we can all go home. Except for us, of course.
Hi. How was it?
Oh, you know, pretty grueling. How's everything been here?
Okay. Well's gone out for about an hour or so. And your mate's really on a high.
Who, Hazel? She been drinking?
No. Can't smell it on her. Maybe it's them happy pills she's been taking for her nerves. Reckon I can do with a few myself.
Oh, Betty.
G'day, Jude. Oh, you're not still cranky with me, are you, for not going?
Of course not, Hazel.
Good. Listen, I've been thinking, there's no point in moping around here all day. Why don't we get out for a while? Head for the hills! You know, unwind a bit.
Yeah, well, I don't feel like it. I mean, I've been at a funeral, you know.
Oh, come on, Jude. I bet you Maxie would say yes. She doesn't want us weeping buckets of tears over her.
Yeah, well, it's not just the funeral. It's the quarantine. It's everything.
Well, why don't you get out for a bit? There's nothing you can do here but sit and wait. I can hold the fort here.
Yeah, but the hills are so far away.
Take my car. It's an old bomb, but goes like a dream. Just put some petrol in it. I don't mind.
Oh, come on, Jude. Just think of them trees and the fresh air.
All right, stop the sale. I'm buying.
G'day. How's it going?
Well, at least I'm getting things in the right order now.
What's the matter, kid? Somebody giving you a hard time?
It's my payer. I didn't get half as much as I was supposed to, and I can't make head or tail of the slip they put in with it.
Ah, show me.
See where it says deduction?
Well, for a start, you only got half a week's pay. Then there's your income tax, deposit on your uniform, and staff social club.
You mean they didn't make a mistake? I still don't understand.
Well, look, I'll write it all down for you tonight when we go out for dinner.
Dinner?
And if you still don't understand, I know a little spot where we can park and spend all night working it out. See you later.
But, Rod...
Boy, would you get an eyeful of that view. Makes you feel pretty insignificant.
Yeah, you're not wrong.
It's so peaceful here. It's like another world.
I've always loved it up here. When George and me was first together, we used to live up here, in the caravan park. Never had no money. And I was pregnant too, but I reckon it's the happiest we ever were together.
Yeah. Well, it's been years since I've been up here. You forget how lovely it is. You know, I reckon this is the best time of year, the fall, with all the leaves changing colour, all the reds and the browns. Tell you what, we'll make an agreement that we'll come back here next fall, okay? What's wrong, Hazel? Hayes, what is it?
Jude... Will you take me away now, please? I want to go home.
I'll teach you how to use chopsticks.
Rod, thanks very much, but I can't come.
What are you talking about?
Well, I promised I'd go and pay Mr. Wallace back as soon as I got some money.
But why didn't you tell me you could come? Are you trying to make a fool out of me?
No, honest. Look, you didn't even give me a chance to say no.
Oh, so it's my fault now, is it? And how are you going to get to this bloke's place?
Well, it's not very far. I was...
Good. Then you won't have any trouble getting there. See you around.
Let me know if she wakes up, B.
Oh, don't you worry, Doc. You'll hear the cheering. I've watched you pretty closely over the last couple of days. You must be feeling very proud of yourself.
Thanks. But I'm just doing my job.
Yes, I know that. But I can't help wondering why. Here, in a prison.
Well, I suppose the obvious answer is that I'm needed here, and there are personal reasons.
Oh, yes, I think she's lovely.
Is it that obvious?
Well, it's not too hard to see. Doctor, I don't know what your plans are, but rich people get just as sick as poor ones. I have a great deal of money. And not a lot that's useful to spend it on. If you had an expensive practice at a good
address...
Thanks,
but I didn't go into medicine for the money.
The integrity of the young. All right. If you change your mind...
Thanks, Mrs. Henderson, but I won't.
Hello, babe.
Hello, you old faker. Now, when are you going to stop bludging and get out of that bed?
Oh, I'll get away with you.
Well, she certainly was a mess when you brought her back. I thought she was having a nervous breakdown.
Well, you could be right, you know. She had one of those before in Wentworth. I mean, she just doesn't seem to be able to cope with anything.
I'll get it.
Thanks, sir.
Mr. Wallace there, please.
Yeah, come in.
Wally.
Yeah? Ha, come in and meet everybody.
I hope I'm not interrupting. I know I said I'd be here earlier, but I took the wrong bus.
Don't worry. Rosemary, this is Judy Bryant, who runs the halfway house.
How are you, love? Nice to meet you. Would you like a coffee?
Well, a cup of tea if it's no trouble.
Betty?
Yes, thanks. Might have known it'd be me.
Yeah, well, you're so happy in the kitchen.
This is Betty. She moans a lot, but she makes a great cuppa. Oh,
pleased to meet you.
Likewise. Tea.
Oh, no, don't bother about paying me back yet, you know. If you're short, wait for a while.
No, thanks a lot, Mr. Wallace. I'd rather pay it back now.
Oh, you are a breath of fresh air.
Come on, sit down. Oh, it is good to see you. Now, tell me, how are you settling down now you've got a job?
Well, the job's all right. Mrs. Beaton's a really nice lady, but...
But no place like home, right?
Right. Guess I'm just not cut out for the big city. I like the bush. Lots of growing room. Everyone knows your name.
Well, why stay here? I know I wouldn't if I felt like that.
Well, I can't let Dad down. I'd just be a burden if I went home. Besides, I rang him up last night. Guess you could say I told a few fibs. Thinks I'm doing well. He's... really proud of me.
Honey, one of the hardest things about leaving home is not having anyone to talk to.
I already found that out.
Well, I tell you what. If you're looking for a friend, or maybe two, we've got Wally and I. Isn't that right, Wally?
That sure is right.
None of those health fads. Booze and fags. I reckon that's what kept me going. Built up me constitution.
Well, we'll talk about it when you're fully recovered, Lizzie.
Here you are, Lizzie. I have a surprise for you. It's a letter from England. Mrs. Morris has been holding it until you got better, but I think it might help buck you up.
Oh, bugger it. I haven't got me specs. Could you read it for me, Mrs. Powell?
Right. It's from Nicolson.
I knew that.
He says, Dear Elizabeth, your letters are a real treat, so much so that I figured 12,000 miles is too far for old mates to be apart.
He's a real charmer, that one.
Next month, I have to make a business trip to the East, and since it's only a hop, skip and jump from here, from there to good old Aussie, I've decided to pop in and see you and that family of yours. What do you think of that?
God. No, he can't. Now what am I going to do?
I don't want to leave. I know it sounds ridiculous. But not right now. Not just yet.
No. You start telling yourself that you're used to being in here. And having nothing. But it's not true. I'm so tired of everyone leaning on me. I think at this stage I forget I'm a woman. And that perhaps there's someone I can lean on. I need you, Tony. Don't go, not tonight. Stay with me. It's all we're ever going to have.
I really want you to be, you know that. The officers.
They won't check for a couple of hours. Let's not waste it.
You sure?
Christmas too, when morning comes around.